All you can say is there are no winners. I'll never see my brother again. Them two girls have gone to jail. Never been jailed before. I've just been talking to the girls' parents and they're in bed. I just have my arm around trying to, because they're not their fault. And we've got two kids now without the mother. All because of a bloody dog. You know, I mean, this dog thing has been going on for such a long time. I don't know why they've got these big dogs. It must be status or something. Fellas have got them, we can't fight. They have to have a dog with them. I don't know what this is all about. It doesn't make any sense to me. It's, you know, simplest thing in the world is to get a muzzle. Now, you can afford a tin of dog food, you can afford a muzzle. Pound. From a pound upwards. You know, and it doesn't do the dog any harm. They get all the tree huggers saying, oh, we can't have muzzles on dogs. The Chuckle Brothers down in Darnstead haven't been back to me. You're getting little girls getting killed by dogs and in the streets, jays and all this. You've got to understand, if a dog is big enough to do that, then it's a weapon, it's dangerous. You know, that dog, I mean, it was foaming at the mouth. It kept a gang of policemen at bay, and they were brave men, them two neighbours. And I'm from Richard Kelly Close, and the people down there are fantastic. The pub, the farmers, I mean, Clifford drank there all his life. I used to say he owned that with the money he spent there. But they've departed from him. You know, I feel so guilty that I wasn't with him at the party. I found out about my brother's death by looking on the television or on the newspapers. No one told me, Dad. This is peacetime, you know. I mean, he was a soldier at one time, but this is just like the time of his life now. And Cliffy lived every day. He was disabled. I used to go around and get papers for people who were disabled for him. I used to go and get the papers for him. Well, that type of guy, you know. I can't really think of a worse death, can you?
What do you think of the punishment these women have received?
Well, to be honest, I mean, I've got to be honest about it. It may deter some people, but they'll do 12 months, maybe 6 months. Okay, you might think I'm saying, oh, it's not enough. But really, I don't give a damn, because that's in the past now. All this business about increasing the punishment, and those fields down there in Downstreet, they're saying, we're going to put chips into them. Well, that's not going to save a dog's life, a chip. You've got to put muzzle. That's after the event. I mean, Dave, you're talking like, oh yeah, we'll do this after. You know, that's only a cheap way of getting out of it, because there's an election coming. They know there's millions of dog owners who won't want muzzles.
DCI Melbourne, this is another horrific dog attack on Merseyside. What's going to be done now about this? How are Merseyside Police going to crack down on these dog owners?
Merseyside Police's message to the public is that you should be a responsible dog owner. You should face the consequences of your actions. If you are going to own a dog, then you need to take your responsibility seriously. You need to make sure that they're adequately exercised, that they have fresh water, food. If they need medical attention, then you take them to the vet and you get the treatment that they require. You have a duty of care to your dog. You also have a duty of care to the public, and you should make sure that your dogs are not allowed to go out and attack anybody. If dogs are found to be mistreated, or if they do attack members of the public, then we would urge that people call the police and let us know. In these circumstances, if you see a dog that's dangerously out of control, then dial 999.